Okay, we're talking with Jane Wheedland and Bill Morrison, who have just come out with a new comic book called Lady Robotica. Let me ask you, first of all, what's the main story behind this, and how did you guys come up with the idea?
That's a tall order. The main idea is it's all about Jane Wheedland, who is abducted by aliens, experimented upon, and then transformed into a cyborg superhero. That's kind of in a nutshell.
Yes, and it's based on real life experience.
Now, was this your idea, and you came to Bill and said, "Hey, I've got this idea," or is this something you guys were just kicking around one day and decided, "Hey, let's do a comic book"? Or how did that work out?
We met at SuperCon three or four years ago,
yeah.
And became instant buddies, and immediately wanted to work together on something. So it was pretty natural that it would be a comic book. So we kind of came up with it simultaneously, and. It's been really, it's funny because it's been going on for a while because both of us have really busy lives, but now that it's finally coming to fruition and it's getting released, the debut at Comic-Con San Diego in July, I couldn't be more excited. And I've been excited for 3 years, but now I'm, bubbling over with excitement because I can't believe I'm going to get to be a superhero.
Now, is this going to be a limited run number of issues, or is this something you...
Yeah, the original story will be 5 issues, and then we'll put that together into a deluxe graphic novel. And Jane is actually working on music to go with the story. So we'll have a companion CD, or we're talking about maybe doing a thumb drive.
Yeah, we're talking, it would be fun to use, even newer technology than CDs. It'd be cool if it came on a thumb drive, or I don't know. We're bouncing around tons of ideas, and now that we have a great story and great characters and great music, now we're talking about possibly making a musical out of it too.
So it could be something Lady Robotica on tour, or something like the Star Wars groups do.
I would love to do that. Even whether or not I play. Hey, kid. Kids, whether or not I play Lady Robotica, all that kind of stuff is still to be decided, because frankly it might be amazing to have a 20-year-old play Lady Robotica, and I could just be the musical director or something. But I don't know, it's just so fun to play around in this universe, and it feels like the possibilities are endless.
Now, we've seen both Marvel and DC kind of experiment a little bit with motion comics. Has that been anything that you guys have discussed on this one, since you can incorporate music and some sound effects and some different things with voice talent, that maybe a Lady Robotica motion comic might be coming?
We have not yet discussed it, but we're planning on discussing it now this afternoon.
Yes.
I want royalties.
As soon as you turn the camera off, we're going into meetings.
Wait a minute. We got to renegotiate this deal. Now, okay, on another thing. You were in Bill and Ted.
Yes.
As Joan of Arc.
Yes.
Keanu Reeves recently said he's up for Bill and Ted 3. As an alumnus, what do you think of the chances that we'll see a Bill and Ted 3 at any point in the future?
Oh, man. That seems so unlikely to me. But if they have one, wouldn't it be rad if they let my character come back?
It's time travel. You never know.
You never know.
I hear that you're a big steampunk fan.
I am.
You're collecting artifacts and items for a new studio?
I'm currently building a recording studio in my basement. My boyfriend and I are a production team. We do, production, engineering, mixing, songwriting, playing, everything you can imagine, because we're both longtime musicians. And our studio has a steampunk theme. I believe it might be the first steampunk recording studio, and it's coming along beautifully, and we're finally getting past the construction stage and into the decorating stage, which is the part that I love, choosing colors and stuff. And I saw some steampunk guys, and I ran up to them all excited and took some pictures of them, and the guy ended up gifting me his steampunk rifle, so that's going to go on the wall in the studio, and it'll be fun. As soon as it's done, I'm definitely going to post pictures online so people can check it out.
That'll be fun. Now, you're doing the music, you're doing the comic book.
Mm-hmm.
Are we going to see you acting anytime soon again?
Yeah, I pretty much have been acting very consistently these days. All independent films, of course, but that's fine because, they're actually more fun, I think, than the big budget. Although I would love to get paid to play one time. I just, there's a movie that's just come out on the whatchamacallit, oh my gosh, the festival, film festival circuit. It's called Stuck. It's a women in prison movie.
That's a Steve Balderson.
Yeah, Steve Balderson directed, and it's black and white, total homage to the, you know, women in prison movies of the 40s and 50s, and that was just a blast to work on. I mean, it's kind of a grim picture, but the most of the laughs come from my character, because I play this sort of slow-witted woman that she drowned her baby and, you know, got put in jail for murder. So, but in my mind, it was an accident. It was just because she wasn't very bright and she was washing the baby and then she drowned the baby. So I just made this whole story up in my mind because I didn't really want her to be a bad guy.
Sure.
And what else? I just wrapped on a movie called Doggy Boogie, which is a really funny family film about competitive dog dancing, which is this crazy sport people are doing. And it's this movie's very wacky, and I loved it because I love dogs, and there were dogs everywhere the whole time. And I play this eccentric character, which is, I guess, what I do these days.
Now, you do a lot of charity work.
I do.
For animal rescue and that sort of thing. What are you involved in right now?
I just finished a benefit in San Francisco for a local group called Muttville that rescues senior dogs, which are the dogs that are the least likely to ever make it out of the pound. And we raised almost $5,000 in that event. So I'm doing lots of, like, you know, I like to work with small groups because, you know, all the money goes to the cause instead of to, you know, postage stamps and solicitation letters and stuff like that. I'm getting ready to do Bowling for Boobies again, which is something I do every year. It is to raise money for women that are fighting breast cancer and can't pay their bills. So again, that's something where 100% of the money goes right to where it's needed. Last year, Bill and I did it together, and the first year I did that event, we made $10,000 for one woman. This past year, with the help of Bill, we raised $100,000. So we've really upped the ante, and now we're helping a lot more people.
And people can find out more at janewiedland.com?
Absolutely.
And does Lady Robotica have a website?
Yes. Yep. Ladyrobotica.com, and it's linked to janewiedland.com. So
okay,
people can
Lady
find
Robotica with a K.
Yes,
with a K.
It is.
Okay, well, I'll let you guys get to the panel. Bill Morrison, Jane Weedland, thank
Thanks,
you very much
Jason.
For your time.
Nice to meet you.